Partnered by Times Influence.
With an indomitable spirit and a ferocious appetite to succeed, he became the fourth shuttler in the world to have won four Super Series titles in a year. Meet the first Indian male badminton player to achieve the world number one ranking.
Srikanth Kidambi.
Bestowed with the Padma Shri and the prestigious Arjuna Award, India's ace shuttler Srikanth is amongst India's brightest badminton prospects.
Initially, we never had an idea like team sport or individual, that we started playing badminton, and my parents also supported into the badminton, because before badminton I was into cricket, but where I was not so comfortable. So then I started playing badminton. Then later Srikanth also followed. For me, it's like always in the hostel life for me. But Srikanth, 10th, 11th is like with the parents. 80% he almost stopped the badminton and came to hometown and he was studying. So 10th and 11th. At that point of time, they pushed him. So where he again back to badminton. That is how he started second time into badminton. And with the less time, he got into the Gopi Chand Academy under Gopi Sir training to represent India is like the goal which when we started playing the badminton. Parents' support is always there for us, and my father's is like, you know, he always supported and into a sport. So it's not into too much of studies. Even in the bad phases, initially when we couldn't got into national, all this, but still he always supported us.
He's put forth many excellent performances during the course of his short career, going from being ranked 240th in 2012 to entering the top 5 in 2015. He further went on to make the country proud by bagging a silver medal at the Commonwealth Games and hopes to continue the winning streak at the Tokyo Olympics in 2020.
I just love to learn from Srikanth, you know, how to be cool and how to manage the things when it was not in your hands or, you know, going out of your hands. The best quality the Srikanth has, like a winning, losing, the expressions or the celebration will be a normal thing. He always says that if he lose the matches, take the positive side. If he wins the matches, you learn. So this is how the Gopis are teaching him. So which is the best part?
Hello and welcome to the third edition of the Mahindra Scorpio presents TOISA Fueling Sports powered by All Out, where I'm in the city of Hyderabad at this fantastic Pulela Gopi Chand Academy, and I've got my baddie racket in hand. I'm going to have one of the top shuttlers of the world and definitely India's best, Srikanth Kidambi, on the show today.
Hi Srikanth.
Hi.
Welcome to the show.
Thank you.
A big fan of what you've done in such a short span of time. Let's just go back to the very beginning. You know, okay. You have a different family background, but your brother is very much like you.
Yeah.
So let's just first talk about how did you pick up a racket in the house? Was it to escape from doing household work or other things?
It's not like that, but my brother started playing first.
Yeah.
So we used to have a stadium which is about 5 minutes from our house.
Yeah.
And that's one of the biggest reasons why my brother started playing. Yeah. And that's also one of the reasons why I also picked up. Yeah. And I used to like started off, you know, as a habit
like after school time pastime, but slowly started liking playing the sport, and then that's how I continued it.
But it wasn't a very popular sport at that point of time. I mean, even if you had to pick up a racket sport, tennis would be more, slightly more known because of Leander and Mahesh.
Yeah.
But you pick up this, which is different only because of your brother?
Well, yeah, I think my brother is one of the reasons why I picked up.
Yeah.
And then probably say, you know, I started liking the sport. And that's one of the biggest reasons, I would say, because you know, everyone should really like what they're doing. Only then they'll definitely succeed.
In your childhood, was Prakash sir like the, you know, the icon that you're watching, or Pulela, Gopichand was the icon? Who are you watching?
Like, I definitely like Prakash sir, but yeah. I really admired Gopi sir. You know, her All England finals was actually the first match I ever watched live. So, like, I really love him. I also met him right after his All England.
Yeah.
So he came to Guntur, so I met him. I still have that photo with me.
Yeah.
So that, like, from that day, I really started admiring him.
And you're here now.
Yeah.
In his academy, it's a surreal experience.
Well, yeah. When I joined here in 2009, it was like a big dream come true. You know, like when I was actually training in Guntur, you know, every time I used to listen about his academy players or about his academy, I used to like it's like. Another world for me, you know. It's like something which is too far, where you can't really reach. But you know, the moment I joined here, it's like a big dream come true. You know, I never even dreamt of it.
But I'll tell you something. I didn't dream of a male badminton player breaking through. Okay, I've been brought up on Saina Naival.
Okay.
I'm hearing PV Sindhu. I'm somehow little bit dur se. I hear one Kidambi is there. Suddenly there's this explosion. It's almost like, you know, you were doing decent stuff prior to that, you know, but for India, but individually, you know, in the super series, suddenly you exploded. I mean, was there a change? Because I read Saina's book, you know, where she said she changed the style of training, you know, she changed her food, she changed all those kind of things to try and come back into contention. What was it that you did?
So you know, I first won my super series in 2014. So, and then by the end of 2014, I became world number 3. But it was the sport, I guess,
wasn't
particularly for the men's singles, it wasn't really that popular. So not many really knew about that, but the Olympics really made a huge change in our country, especially for badminton.
You were one game away maybe from bronze.
Yeah, a few points away. And I think like post the Olympics, I really injured myself very badly, so I had to, I couldn't play for 3 months. And then 2017, at the beginning, it wasn't really that great for me, but suddenly everything worked really well, and you know, I did really well. And then
Sunday to Sunday, victory to victory.
And then 2018, I became world number one. So you know, that particularly that 2017, mid of 2017 until now, I think it's been great 1.5 years for me.
But now you're being mapped by every other opposing team, opposing player. Now, you know, with videography that is there. Now, do you have to have a secret shot in your armor or something different now? Because you're the marked player now.
It'll definitely be there with every opponent. Even we do watch the, you know, other country players' matches, and we do make notes. But it's not really neat to be the same. Like there'll be things which changes with every condition, like with every tournament, like every country we go have different conditions.
Yeah.
So there are slow courts, there are fast courts, so there are different conditions, and we need to really adjust to the local conditions and then play. And then yeah, definitely every opponent has few weaknesses and strengths, and you know, even we do analyze our matches also and then work on our weaknesses.
Another big thing the world seems to always notice about you. You're always very normal about everything.
Okay.
World champion, okay. World number one, okay, you know. But what is this cool exterior of yours?
Like, I particularly feel after that Olympic quarterfinal loss, you know, I really felt bad, you know. I really worked hard for that, but you know, couldn't really achieve it. So post that, you know, post Olympics, you know, I started taking everything easy, you know. It's like, even if I lose a Super Series tournament, you know, I don't really, you know, it doesn't really matter because I have another Super Series coming up in less than a week. So I can really, you know, play well and then prove myself again.
Let's talk about opponents. You've got favorable records against a large number of the top 10 players, but there are one or two that, you know, I see that you have a greater loss as compared to a win record.
Yeah.
So, is there one or two opponents that you you know, switch on a little bit more for in the world?
Well, well, against few opponents like Lee Chong Wei, Chen Long, I really have a bad head-to-head. But again, I've, you know, it's like every day is a new day. You know, every time I play them, I really want to do well. You know, maybe even though I have a bad head-to-head, the next time I play them, you know, I really want to give my best. It's a new day. It's new conditions, so I really want to give my best and you know, do well. You know, try to win. That's it.
Would you say your life-changing power moment in your life would have been the loss in the Olympics? You know, because after that, like you said, you changed your perspective.
Well, definitely it's that Olympics and then the injury I had. So those two were actually the biggest life-changing moments.
Wow. And after that, you just said it doesn't matter anymore.
It doesn't matter anymore. I've been out of sport for 3 months. I lost the biggest tournament in the quarterfinal with just a couple of points. And you know, what else do I have to lose?
And then winning 4 in a year. There are hardly any men in the world that have done it, reaching the world number one position. I mean, he seems to have it all and he's 25. I have to ask him also, where does he have left to go? I mean, he's already been number one. Is it tough to sort of lose that ranking when you get, you know, when you get announced that you're world number one? And then next week when the new ranking comes, okay, I'm no longer world number one. So how is that? Because not too many Indians have actually been number one.
Yeah, so but, I was just very happy, but I couldn't really celebrate it because I was in Commonwealth Games during that. And then the moment I came back within a couple of days, I know the rankings changed again. And then, so I didn't really get time to celebrate, but probably maybe, you know, I'll definitely get another chance.
Just before we go into a break, how many medals in your house now? You have to have a count.
Like I don't really have that count.
40, 50, 100?
Oh, not definitely not 100, probably around 40.
40. I think I'm going to try and instill this sense of celebration with him. You know, maybe that one room in his house where he can celebrate. But for now, I think the celebration of his talent and the gyan that he's actually garnered over the years, we want him to give it to aspiring athletes. So we're going to go meet them and let's see how they can learn from Srikanth, Kidambi. Right here, don't go anywhere.
Okay. Camera roll. Camera roll.
Okay, hello and welcome to the third edition of the Mahindra Scorpio Presents Toys of Unique Sports powered by All Out. Srikanth Kidambi, the champion with us. But we're not doing the champion talk right now. We're doing way beyond the game. So, friends? Too many of them? Very few of them? What's your life like?
Very few, yeah. Very few friends. Mm. Very few friends outside the badminton. So just a small group I have.
You know, whenever you go for these long tours of yours, even if you go, are you a music person? Are you a reading person? How do you like zone into what you have to do
so
in between?
Definitely no reading. No reading for sure. It's like I'm a sleeping person.
Really?
Really, yeah.
You like sleeping?
So I like sleeping the most.
So just before like a tournament or a big match, like all these cricketers listen to music. Do you listen to music?
Not much. It's just about sleeping and then recovering for the next day's match. That's it.
That's it?
That's it, yeah.
So you don't really have like a fixed mantra like a lot of top athletes have, you know, I'll do this, I'll do that.
So the I'll do this mantra is sleeping, yeah. So that's the most, you know, for me, like because we have one match every day, you know, for me to play after a big match to recover for the next match, I really have to give my body that good enough rest for it to recover.
You know, if Superman like, you know, has the powers because of his kryptonite, well, he has his powers because of sleeping.
Because of sleeping.
Personal and professional life, is there any balance required for you at all?
There's definitely no personal life. I keep traveling throughout the year. It's like 2 weeks every month I'm somewhere else, definitely not in India. So I don't really have any personal life. The life I have is that, you know, coming back home, that's it.
Do you watch TV in the house?
Yeah,
I do. Okay. At least he does
at
that.
At least I do that, yeah.
No, only sleeping house. Have a seat, yeah. Let's go. We'll go see those children.
Okay, sure, yeah.
Since you've been on the road for quite a while, you know, in your career, are you a long drive kind of person at all?
Well, yeah, I do sometimes.
Yeah?
Like I go home, which is about 5 hours drive from Hyderabad.
Oh, so that's a long drive. Anyway.
That's a long drive, but I don't do it very often.
Okay.
But that's probably once in 3 months or 4 months. And I don't do it alone, it's with my parents.
Are you a SUV person or a hatchback person?
SUV. Like, I have an XUV, I have a Volvo, I have a Thar. Different wide variety of cars. And I really prefer XUV because it's really very high on road.
Yeah.
And no, that's like, if you are really driving for long distance, I think it'll be a little relaxing and comfortable. Yeah.
Fame for a sportsman in a country like India, without cricket, is hard earned. But once it comes in, then you're one of the unique faces that has that. Okay, so if you say right now in our country, top badminton player, there are only three names that will come to people's mind: two girls and you. So now suddenly with this fan following, how has life changed for you?
Well, definitely there's nothing much that changed. It's probably people are recognizing me whenever I'm on the malls or something. Yeah. Sometimes it's nice, sometimes it's not. Whenever you're in a restaurant having something, when people comes in for a selfie, it doesn't really feel nice. But when you're in a mall doing nothing, I think it's really good.
The 2016 Olympic Games is a big turning point in your career. A, just going to represent India at such a large, you know, occasion. And 2016 was also a time when a number of divisions actually had prospects of medals, you know. So we went over there knowing that we could probably have the best Olympic Games of our career. So describe that experience to me.
Well, I've been to Commonwealth Games in 2014,
right,
in the Asian Games, 2014. So I had that village experience then.
Okay.
But being there at the Olympics is something different because, you know, you get to see the best of the world.
What is the village experience like? Is everybody really relaxed in a village?
Well, yeah, I think that's one of the occasion where you get to meet the other Indian athletes.
Yeah.
Because you don't really see them often because, you know, we have our own schedule and then they have their own schedule. And it's really nice to interact with them. Yeah. Like, you know, I've made few good friends, you know, it's like few weightlifters. And during the Commonwealth Games, I've been to the weightlifting because we shared the same hall.
Every athlete has that breakthrough moment in their career, you know, you feel like this is the moment that I'm going into the next level. We call it the rising moment. So what would be your rising moment in your life?
So the rising moment in my career would be joining the academy first.
Okay.
And in 2011, 2012, when Gopi sir wanted me to focus only on singles and, you know, stop the other two events.
Yeah.
Because I used to play all singles, doubles and mixed doubles until my juniors.
Wow.
So like right after my juniors, he wanted me to focus only on singles.
Okay.
So I think that's one of the biggest like a rising moment for me, because, you know, the moment, you know, within 6 months after I shifted to singles, I won the international challenge.
Wow.
Beating the then world junior champion.
Oh, okay. The children that, you know, we're meeting right now, we've got to select a small bunch of kids that are playing in the under 9s, under 11s. We'll go meet them right now and let's share some experience.
Yeah, right. Definitely.
And the group that we have today is a small group, but they're already playing under 9, under 11, and they're right here behind us. Hello!
Hi.
Some of you guys are playing already in tournaments. So we're going to ask a few questions to Kidambi sir. Who's going to ask the first question? You have to raise your hands.
My name is Shravya, and how to prevent tournament fear? Like, I was having a lot of tournament fear.
So I've seen few players who are a little scared. They play really well in practice, but they couldn't really do well in tournaments. But you can't really avoid that because you can't really stop playing tournaments. So the only thing you can do is probably play more tournaments and enjoy losing.
And doesn't it happen in those, not just the tournament, in the crucial points? They say, you know, your muscles get more tighter. Even when in cricket people are 99, they're reaching 100. So it must have happened to you also in your that final point.
Well, that definitely happens, but you know, at this age, you can't really ask them to do different things. But it's only thing you can do is probably play more tournaments.
My name is Kavya. So, which diet do you have?
Do you eat also, sir? You look so fit. A lot of people eat very less after a point of time.
I don't really have to. You know, my body takes in as much as I eat.
Okay.
And doesn't even show up. I feel you know, there's not really too much at this age to do. I would say stop eating all those junk food, the roadside food.
How you balance your studies and sports?
I really got a good support from my school and colleges, so when I was able to do it. But and it's also the same for you both, you know, like you have to really do your homework properly and, you know, plan everything in such a way that you'll be able to give enough time to, you know, the sport and also the education.
So my question is, what is your secret of playing very good badminton?
It's just the practice. Practice is the only thing that can really help you get better. There are no secrets, it's just the practice.
My name is Sloka.
Sloka.
And my question is, how to manage injuries?
Really a tough question for this age. But again, yeah, injuries are something which you can't really predict. From the beginning, I think it's just not just the sports person, but every individual. I think it's really important to do a proper stretching, do some, maybe some jogging or walking every day. I think it'll definitely help them.
Yeah.
Perfect. What's your question?
My name is Ramit. I want to ask you that, do you ever felt distracted by seeing that how many fans you have while playing a match?
That's a very good question. Right?
Well, not really, because they never try to distract me, because they always, you know, really want me to do well. So they only keep encouraging me.
But never ever. Some people are screaming, "We love you, Kidambi!"
It doesn't happen in badminton. Yeah. It's just the cricket.
You also play? Yeah. What age group do you play?
It'll happen for you.
Yeah.
I play in under 11 years.
Raja, I think you're going to get a big fan following. Give me a high five. Yeah, there you go. Okay, so do you want to see Kidambi sir do some skills with the racket? Okay, perfect. Who has a good backhand here? See? So backhand is a problem always. Huh? All right, let's see. So what would you give like a 5-minute coaching camp to youngsters who are just picking up? What is the first thing that they should?
Well, just because you're playing tomorrow,
yeah.
Just tell me how you hold a grip.
Well, yeah. Grip.
So it is like this. And then how you hold a backhand grip. Yeah, good.
Under 9, under 11, that's the future, talking to our future as well. It's been an absolute pleasure to bring these fantastic and inspirational athletes to you on this third edition of Mahindra Scorpio Presents Toys of Feeling Sports, powered by All Out. Like I said, it's been my absolute pleasure traversing the country to bring all these athletes to you. Hope you got inspired, and we'll catch you soon. Bye-bye.